Hey friends, if you love photography and like to sell your photos and videos online, make sure you subscribe, hit the bell icon and turn on all the notifications so that you never miss any video guides from the Teaching Dog channel.
And here I come. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. This is Dr. Arindam and you are watching the Teaching Dog. And today I'll be telling you 5 reasons why you should not be starting stock photography. Welcome back friends. For those who are seeing me for the first time, I'm a medical doctor and a stock photographer and I make videos regarding stock photography. I have made many guides regarding stock photography in this channel. Make sure to check the links in my video description to see them all. Now this topic may come as a surprise because normally in my channel I always post motivational video. I always post the videos regarding why you should start stock photography, how you can improve your stock photography, how you can improve your sales, even if you are struggling, how you should and why you should continue uploading in stock photography agencies. But from various comments I see in those videos, from various direct messages that come to me in my Facebook Messenger and Instagram, and different posts that I see in the newly formed Facebook group, the link to which is given below, I have come to the conclusion that there are few groups of people who are not doing it right, who have started stock photography, but they are quitting. So I have decided to make this video regarding why you should not start stock photography if you have one of these 5 things. The first reason why you should not start stock photography is if you do not love photography but you are doing this only for money, then my request is please do not start stock photography. There are many guys in my channel who are just willing to earn online somehow. Either they want to go on YouTube, they want to make some ad, they want to design some graphic or they want to sell some photos, but they are not clearly focused. What I mean to say is, if you are doing this just for money, just for income, then this thing is not for you at all. Only if you love clicking photos, only if you love creating videos, only if you love to draw graphic designs, you love to create illustrations, then only upload your work into Shutterstock and other agencies from which you can earn money. But the money comes later. The first is your love for work. The first is your passion of art. If that is number one, please do that. Continue uploading without worrying about sales. If you have got potential, if your artwork is unique, if your photos have got unique touch, you will definitely earn. I love photography and I started uploading without worrying about sales. I got my first sale very late. I got my first sale after 255 uploads and 3 months after I started my first uploading. So you get my point here, right? So first is your love for photography, then come the sales. So if you are in it for money, do not start stock photography. Reason number 2 why you should not start stock photography is if you expect to become rich overnight. Yes friends, this is one of the most common misconceptions that I see. New stock photographers almost always complain that they are not earning much. They are earning only 0.25 cents per photo. They are only earning $3 in a month. Well, that's the fact. That is the truth. At the end of my first month, I had $0.75 because I sold only 3 photos. Then after my second month, the total earning was, I think, $2.25 because in the next month, I sold few more photos. Then my number started going up and I earned total, I made around $100 in first 5 to 6 months, I think. So you see my point. If you expect to earn $1,000 or 50,000 Indian rupee in 1 month, it's possible. Maybe it's possible after 2 to 3 years of huge hard work, when you have got good portfolio, then it's possible. But if someone tells you just by doing stock photography, you can quit your job, you can quit everything and you can start earning full time, then it is not possible when you are a new stock photographer. Remember, it's a marathon, it's not a sprint. It means you will not become rich overnight, but definitely you will earn money over a long period of time. So if you expect to become rich very soon, if you want to earn very huge amount of money very soon, then maybe stock photography is not for you. You can do weddings and other event photography, freelancing, but not stock photography. Reason number three why you should not start stock photography is if you lack honesty, if you lack creativity, and if you are trying to copy someone else's work, or if you are trying to download something from Google, Pinterest and all other imaging, free imaging websites, and you are trying to edit and upload them, or you are simply changing the color tone and uploading them, do not start stock photography. Trust me guys, it's the creativity inside you, the artist inside you, that will take you a long way. It's your creativity which differentiates you from the competition, which separates you from the market. If you are new, you will definitely go far ahead. But if you are trying to copy someone else's work, if you are trying to make the exact same file as one of the best sellers, it will not work. The thing which is already selling good will continue to sell if you make an exact copy. But if you give something new, if you give it your personal touch, then your file will soon become the best seller. Almost every day I get a comment that, sir, my Dreamstime account has been blocked. Sir, my Shutterstock account has been deactivated. Sir, my Adobe Stock account, I cannot log in. All of those are the guys who download from Google, somehow edit them and upload into those agencies. You see, if you lack creativity and if you are trying to cheat, you will get caught. There are image searching algorithms which will easily detect your images as being a digital exact replica of something that is already existing in the internet. So definitely they will try to trace you and your work, and if they find that your images are simple copy of the images that are existing in the web, they will simply block your account. And even if your photos get approved, you may become very happy, but very soon your account will be blocked. So my point is, if you cannot create your own photos, if you do not know how to frame photos, if you do not know how to create graphic designs, if you do not have any basic idea how to shoot a video on your own, then do not start stock photography. You cannot be successful by copying or downloading someone else's work. Reason number four, you should not start stock photography, or even if you have started, you should quit stock photography if you are expecting your few photos to sell. Most of the time, almost 80%, the complaint is, sir, I have uploaded 12 photos, but I'm not getting any sales. I have uploaded 20 photos, I have approved 20 photos, but I'm not getting any sales. My dear, it's not that easy. As I told you in earlier point, my file started selling after 255 approved photos. I was a poor photographer, alright, I didn't know what I was doing. Still, my file sold almost after 250 uploads, and that too after 3 months. And that was the competition 1 year ago. Now, after I have created this channel, many of my brothers and sisters are contributing, so the competition is high. Alright, many of stock photographers already tell me, stop your channel, stop uploading videos, you are trying to destroy the market. But I don't believe. I believe someone, if he or she is creative, definitely there is a chance for them. But what I mean to say is, if you upload just few photos and if you wait for sale and then you do not get any result, and if you become demoralized, then that is not the way why you should start stock photography. This is the problem with the new stock photographers or the new guys who have signed their account. Why I know this? Because I have a referral links of all the websites in my video description, right? When I log in into Shutterstock and when I click into my referrals, I can see all those, the names of all those guys or the emails that have signed up using my referral links. And most of them, almost 95 to 96% of them, I see they have uploaded only 10 to 15 photos and naturally their downloads are zero. This will happen to every one of you if you just trying to, if you are just trying to wait for sales by uploading few photos, which will never happen. You should stop worrying about downloads or sales and you should continue uploading, uploading and uploading without fail. As I told you in one of my previous videos, your target should be at least getting 500 high quality, unique and different photos get approved in your portfolio. Then only you can expect some regular sales. So as I told you, do not start stock photography if you cannot work hard and if you cannot upload without getting sales. Only if you are uploading much, then only you get sale. So if you are one of those type who will upload few, wait for sale and then you will upload more, then stock photography simply not for you at all. And reason number 5 that I personally feel is, one should not start stock photography if he or she is not good in English. Yes guys, it may not be fair to those friends who have not studied in English medium, but basic knowledge of English is very important because title, description, keywords, categories, everything should be done in English only. And understanding English language is very, very, very important. I know I am saying it now and it's quite funny because if you are seeing this video till now, it's obvious that you understand English. And those who are not good in English must have turned off this video by now. But it's your duty to tell any friend or photographer or cousin who is trying to do stock photography, but if he or she is not good in English, then please tell him or her that, sir or ma'am, please learn some basic English, then only try your luck in stock photography. This is the main reason why I make English videos mainly. I try to make videos in Hindi. It's easier for the friends to understand in Hindi, but the problem is they don't get good sales, they fail in stock photography due to the fact that they understand what I am saying, but when it comes to title, captions, keywords, everything, their photos are getting rejected and they are getting demoralized. They are telling me that I am misguiding them. So I have decided that the main content of this channel should be in English, but the main thing is every stock photographer should know good English. Well, those were the 5 conditions in my opinion why someone should not start stock photography. And as you know, in every video of mine, there is a code of the day, which is a secret thing, a word that you should write in the comment section, and that will prove that you are watching this video till now. So the code of the day for today's video is JBL. So please type JBL in the comment section and I will know that you are watching this video till now. So that was it for today. If you find this video helpful, please press the like button and also share this video with your friends and cousins who love photography, because our aim here is to build a strong community of stock photographers. Thanks for watching. This is Dr. Arindam and you are watching The Teaching Doc, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.